that the publisher of the Mail on Sunday has lost an appeal at the Court of Appeal in the privacy case brought by the Duchess of Sussex, Meghan Markle. We can go live now to our correspondent, Ivor Bennett, who is outside the court. Ivor, I think this will come as a bit of a surprise, won't it, given that the Duchess admitted misleading the court in the original case?
Yeah, as you say, in the last 30 minutes we've had this ruling, and it means that Meghan has won this latest, possibly final round in her legal battle with the publisher of the Mail on Sunday, Associated Newspapers Limited, over their reproduction, publication of parts of a letter she sent to her estranged father, Thomas Markle, in August 2018. It means an earlier ruling at the High Court, which saw her win that privacy case without a trial, is now upheld. So as before, there will not be a trial. And we have just had reaction from the Duchess of Sussex in a very strongly worded statement indeed. I can read part of it to you now. She says, "From day one, I have treated this lawsuit as an important measure of right versus wrong. The defendant has treated it as a game with no rules. The longer they dragged it out, the more they could twist facts and manipulate the public, even during the appeal itself, making a straightforward case extraordinarily convoluted in order to generate more headlines and sell more newspapers, a model that rewards chaos above truth." She goes on to say, "In the nearly 3 years since this began, I have been patient in the face of deception, intimidation and calculated attacks." So extremely strongly worded, which gives a sense of a very clear sense of just how bitter a dispute this is. The Duchess of Sussex claimed that that publication of parts of her letter to her father was a breach of her privacy and copyright. She sued the publisher, Associated Newspapers Limited. She won her case in the High Court earlier this year without a trial. ANL, the publisher, argued that that case should go to trial. That was and appealed that at a three-day hearing last month. And it was at that hearing that the Court of Appeal heard some new evidence that was seen at the time as potentially explosive. That was what you're referring to. It came from the former communications secretary to the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, who claimed in a witness statement that Meghan wrote that letter to her father in the understanding that it could be leaked. Now, the Duchess denied in her written statement that she thought it definitely would be leaked, more recognised it as a possibility, with her lawyers arguing that it was clearly intended to be private. Now, as it happened, the Court of Appeal, the judge, Sir Geoffrey Voss, said they deemed that new evidence to be of little assistance, so it was not as explosive as originally thought. He went on to say in his ruling, "The Court of Appeal upheld the judge's decision that the Duchess had a reasonable expectation of privacy in the contents of the letter. Those contents were personal, private, and not matters of legitimate public interest." So Meghan has won this latest and quite possibly final round of her legal battle with the publisher of the Mail on Sunday.